When we defined a variable, we said that it represented a quantity in a program whose value could change. Once a variable exists, or has been declared, we can change its value at any time, not just when it's initialized, but at any time during a program's execution. We can change its value as many times as we need to. To change the value of a variable, we use the assignment operator, or to us, the equals sign. We say that it performs right-to-left evaluation, which means that the right-hand side is evaluated fully into one single value, then that value gets assigned to the left-hand side variable. So we can think of the assignment operator, or equals sign, as acting like a left-facing arrow. As we've seen already, the stuff on the right-hand side can be some literal value, another variable, or any legitimate Java expression. Let's take a look at some examples of these. Here we see a number of examples of variable assignment. In all cases, the right-hand side of any assignment operator is evaluated fully, rolled up into one single value, and then that value is assigned to the variable on the left-hand side. For example, in this third example, we take the value of x, which was set to 20, add it to y, which was also set to x, and then add 50 to it, resulting in 90. We then take that one single value of 90 and assign it to the variable z on the left-hand side. Pretty simple stuff. In this fifth example, we see another example of an expression. The SAM object has a method to retrieve its age, and this entire right-hand side evaluates to one single number. That number is then assigned to the age variable and overwrites the value of 20 it had in the previous step. As we said before, we can update the value of a variable as many times as we need to. As we've said, variables represent one type of identifier in Java, and therefore have to follow all the Java rules on naming. You know, things like numbers and letters only, no spaces, no leading numbers, and so forth. But beyond those minimum requirements, variables should also follow good naming conventions. Variable names should be descriptive and should clearly indicate what they represent. Variable names shouldn't be too short or too long. As Goldilocks would say, they should be just right. By good conventions, variables should be noun-based and represent things. Variables should begin with a lowercase letter and should be in camel case, where any words after the first one begin with a capital letter internally. And finally, we should avoid using underscores and dollar signs in good variable names. Note that none of these are musts, but rather shoulds, but they are all very well-established shoulds in Java convention. The goal in all of this is simple. We ideally want all our Java code to read like a book and be self-documenting. Someone who may not be familiar with your code should still be able to look it over and get a quick sense of what it's doing, simply from the specific variable names you're using. So here are examples of some variable names in Java. For starters, all of these names represent legitimate identifier names by the minimum requirements of Java. But the names on the left, although they are allowable, for various reasons wouldn't be the best names to use. The ones on the right, however, are improved versions. In all cases, can you see why? The first one on the left is too nondescriptive. X what? The one on the right is more specific. Same problem for the second one. The right side is more specific about what kind of string it is. And the same problem for the third one. What kind of name? The fourth variable should be improved by using the camel case convention, as shown on the right. For the fifth variable, we'd prefer not to use underscores in the name, so we'll remove them and use camel case instead. Same problem for the sixth variable, the test score. Here, the convention of variable names beginning with a lowercase letter takes precedence over the fact that Joe is a proper noun. For the seventh variable, we might want to improve that by spelling out the word dollar, which isn't really clear from the context here. Finally, for the last variable name, this might be a little excessively long, and we might better consider shortening it a little bit. Now, for every naming convention, there are always some reasonable exceptions. There are cases in which it would be probably just fine to use short, terse variable names when their meaning is pretty much clear from their usage context. Often we'll see this with temporary throwaway variables, such as in these cases. For example, it's quite common to see single letter variables, such as I, J, and K for loop counters, or a simple str for some string, or a ch for some temporary input character. In cases like these, where the meaning is obvious from the context, don't worry too much about short variable names such as these. Java is what's called a strongly typed language. What this means is, we have to be upfront about our intentions for variables by declaring them to be of certain data types from the beginning. Then once we have declared a variable, we cannot change its data type later on. Furthermore, the Java compiler is very strict about assigning values to our variables once they are declared, and it will not allow you to assign any incompatible data. However, mixed type expressions are okay though. You can assign smaller data types to larger data types, but not larger data types to smaller data types. For example, a long-sized integer can easily accommodate a byte-sized integer, but you could not safely assign a long to a byte integer. Here is a full list of compatible data types in Java. Variables of any data type on the right can safely be assigned to variables of the data type on the left. For example, a 4-byte int can safely accommodate a 1-byte byte, a 2-byte short, or another int, as well as even a 2-byte char, but it cannot accommodate a long because a long is 8 bytes. Similarly, because a double is the largest numeric type, it can hold any of the other numeric types. But however, booleans can only contain boolean values, and chars can only hold other char values. And with that, we end this segment on variable creation.